Hey there, Saguto golfers. Tom Saguto here with a special guest today. I got Jess Frank from the Jess Frank Golf Academy. We're here at the Stack and Tilt Camp in Miami, Florida. And today, we're gonna show you the most important skill every golfer needs to be good. And you need this. This is the number one fundamental in golf. And Jess, what is the number one fundamental we have here today?
It's low point control. It's the one point of contact on the ground that most golfers really struggle with. And today we're going to show you how to do it.
What Jess is saying is that expert golfers will hit the ground in the same spot every single time, never hitting behind the golf ball. The worst players, the poor players, often do stuff like this. You know, the flip and fall back.
The flip, fall back, they miss the ground completely, you know, they top it. So these are things that golfers struggle with all the time. And the number one word that comes up is consistency. How can I be consistent? Control your low point.
What we're gonna do here today is you're gonna be 100 million times more consistent than when you were before watching this video. What's that sound? Are you excited to get started today?
That's awesome, Tom.
So you wanna have one point of contact, right? That's why you're here, right? Jess, who doesn't want it?
Everybody wants it.
We all want it.
So you get good.
That crispier KFC all day long.
Crispy KFC and mashed potatoes.
Don't forget the mashed potatoes and gravy. The secret to having one point of contact every single time is with your shoulders. Your shoulders are a circle and the club follows the shoulders. So as I take the club back here, if I turn my shoulders in a circle, the club will trace the same circle, which if you're tracing the same circle back, trace the same circle going through, you're gonna find one point of contact every single time, right, Jess?
Every time, 100%.
It's just pure as butter.
It becomes easy that way.
So how do we do that, Jess? What is the key to keeping our shoulders turning in that circle in the golf swing and having one point of contact? What would you suggest we do right off the bat?
Well, the number one thing I would say for most people, Tom, and what your explanation is just beautiful, I love it, of the shoulders turning in a circle, would be keeping the weight forward. And I think that is the secret sauce of hitting the ground in the same spot every single time, because so many golfers fail to do that and then they miss the ground, they top it, or you know, just that's the inconsistent contact on the face. So keeping the weight forward will move the bottom of the swing forward as well. So I think that's just the key to that one point of contact.
And that's beautifully said. So go ahead and get set up here.
Yep.
What this orange stick represents is Jess's contact point. So your contact point on the ground. There should never be a divot behind this line. If you hit behind this line, you hit fat, and then it's just never fun from there. It's ugly. We don't even want to talk about it. It's unspeakable.
No. We don't speak about that at all. We just want to flush it. That's all. We want to hit it solid.
Yeah, so this will be the last day you ever see somebody shift their weight or do anything like that. So go ahead and get set up to the imaginary ball.
Got
and
it.
You can do this at home because we've got this alignment stick.
Yep.
You can do this in your lawn. If you got weeds, you can knock them out.
Yep.
And so if Jess wants to have one point of contact, as we just demonstrated, he would turn his shoulders in a circle, keeping his weight forward. Doing that, you can see how he hasn't shifted off the ball. If he was to shift his weight off the ball like most golfers and take the club back at the same time, he moves his swing circle way behind the contact point. So that club's going...
We're gonna hit the ground.
Ooh.
Way behind it.
That's
the most you could hit behind it. If you shift over here and hit, that's where the centers are gonna go. They're gonna go back behind the ball.
The weight forward helps you to turn your shoulders in a circle and stay over that one spot for one point of contact, right?
Absolutely, 100%. That's what so many golfers, they get wrong when they're doing it. And when they shift, and which you talk about all the time beautifully, is that they shift to the right and then they hit behind it, or they hit it thin because their arms break down.
Mm.
You know, because they get sick of hitting the ground so much that they pull their arms in, so it causes a whole host of other problems.
Right, and sometimes golfers can think, well, I pulled my arms in, that's the problem. When really, in reality, the weight was already gone.
Yeah.
It was already, they already compromised it here in the backswing.
100%, and then the low point moves way behind the ball. So if the low point is just in front of the stick here, if we're trying to do that, and we shift it to the right and the low point shifts way back, we've got no downward ascent, we're swinging up on the ball, so there's a whole host of problems that could go on, for sure.
So what you're saying is you could fix a lot of golf swing problems just by learning how to control your contact point.
Absolutely, you can control, if you can control the golf club and you can control the grip and the shaft and the head, you can control that low point every single time. And I think Tom and I could stand up here for hours, days, weeks, and never hit behind the ball because we know how to control the low point. And that's the first thing that That is the number one fundamental in golf. That's what I always love to talk about. That's the number one fundamental in golf before anything else. When people come to me and they say, well, I'm trying to keep my head down, left arm straight, I go, well, how are you hitting the ball if you're never hitting the ball solid? Let's learn how to hit the ball solid first. Forget about all that other nonsense.
Right, right. So we're going to clear a lot of thoughts out of your mind, and we're going to get right into the drill right now. So the first step to controlling the low point is the weight forward.
Yes.
And with the weight forward, we often prescribe 55% on your front leg in the setup. So go ahead and demonstrate that for us, Jess. And this could feel like for you, when you get in this position, you'll see your shoulders over your hips, over your knees in a straight line like this. You see that?
Yep.
And what this tells you is that you are over the golf ball, you're covering the golf ball. If you're not doing this right, you'll probably look like you're over here, behind the ball, or if you're doing too much, you'll actually be in front of the ball. We want to have perfectly over the ball. So get in front of a mirror at home and verify that you're not too off in one direction or the other. You want to be perfectly over the ball. That's your 55%, 60% on your left leg.
Yeah, and I would say there are just, you know, I would say every golfer that I've ever seen could use work in their setup. We like to call P1, but it's our setup that so many people are told to tilt to the right, and as soon as they start tilting to the right, they're no longer stacked. They're no longer shoulders over the hips, over the knees, over the feet. That's where, and then all of a sudden, their weight is already on their back foot. And sometimes you don't even realize it because you've been told at address, tilt to the right. And so, you know, that will also move the low point back as well.
Yeah, so most of you, when you do this, knowing the average golfer and how they're used to this, they're gonna actually feel, you might feel like you're here. In a way, it might feel like you're tilted down.
Sure.
A lot of people have mentioned that on the lesson too. They feel like they're over it like this.
Right. Yeah.
And they say, how could I possibly hit a golf ball from there? Well, that's what we're gonna do next.
Yeah,
we're gonna learn how to hit it.
Yeah.
So this drill, first what we're gonna do is we have no golf ball. You just have to learn how to control your contact point. So what Jess is gonna do here is we got the weight forward. The next piece we're gonna add in is keeping the arm straight. Because the left arm, the lead arm, this is like a compass. You ever draw a perfect circle in school?
Absolutely.
The lead arm is that compass arm and always returns to the same spot every single time. So you draw that perfect circle every single time.
Right.
So keeping the lead arm straight is gonna help Jess return the club to that same spot on the ground in front of that orange stick. And you can go to Home Depot, pick up one of these sticks for $2.19. It's the best investment in your golf game in history.
Yes, yes, yes. And we're gonna add to those too. But yes,
oh, yeah.
get one for sure for the couple bucks. It could change your golfing life. Absolutely.
And I'd say do this until you never hit behind this. I mean, you will seriously see an improvement in your game without a ball just by doing this.
100%. Yeah, you'll hit the ball more solid, taking small swings, and just hitting into the back of the golf ball every single time with the low point forward, than trying to make big swings and try to swing as fast as you can with the driver. Of course, everybody wants to hit it far, but you have to hit the ball solid and you have to compress the golf ball against the face. And I think that's where a lot of people miss. You know, they want to just hit it as far as they can. And if you want to get better at golf, you have to go, I always like to call like small to big. So small and slow to big and fast. You know, so I always start with these little swings here. This is great.
Look at that.
For any level of player, from beginners to higher level players if they're struggling with contact. And you could see that, you know, we're hitting in front of this line every time.
Yeah, and nothing's changing. There's not a lot of variables here.
No.
So it makes it really simple to repeat. A lot of golfers want to rush to the end. They want to,
yes.
I want to go to the full swing right now.
Yeah.
Like you just said, small to big I think that's a beautiful way to work on your swing. Mm-hmm. If you can't master the small, what makes you think you're going to master the big, right?
And you know what I find a lot too in with working with golfers is that they start to take smaller swings and hit the ball farther because they're compressing the golf ball, and hitting it more solid. And so they're creating, what I always tell them, like they're creating ball speed because the compression off the face creates ball speed, which sends the ball farther, you know, instead of trying to swing as big as you can and ball doesn't go anywhere. So.
And that's that mashed buttery feeling against that face that you're going to have.
Yeah.
So Jess just demonstrated the first part of the drill. Do this until you don't hit behind that line. Then take it out the driving range right here or in your backyard, wherever, and plop some golf balls down and just focus on never hitting behind this stick. And I guarantee you, if you keep the weight forward and the lead arm straight, just focusing on little half shots here, pretty much going from quarter to quarter, keeping the arms straight the whole way, you're going to see crispy, buttery, mashed potato feeling off that club face.
Very crispy.
Would you like to demonstrate one for us, Jess?
Absolutely, Tom. So I'm gonna go ahead, I'm gonna put about 55 to 60% of my weight on my front leg. I think one of the things that I think people get confused a little bit about the a weight forward is that everybody thinks that they have to move way forward, and you really don't have to. You just have to, stabilize your left leg, weight on the left, and then with the, like you said, with the arm straight and hit these little shots.
Oh, that sounded good.
Yeah, and so you can see here is that I made my weight's on my front, my arms are straight. I haven't collapsed my arms, which you see constantly from most people because they're always trying to lift the ball in the air, fall onto their back foot, and that's where you get the slice and the inconsistent contact and stuff that we like to cure.
So what Jess just beautifully said is that this fixes the biggest problems in golf.
Yeah, absolutely.
And it's so simple, right? We're just working on basics here.
Yeah.
But if you can feel that and do that every single time, imagine what happens when you get up to your full swing. It's gonna repeat. You gotta train this throughout the golf swing, and the whole focus of the golf swing, the number one key is this. So Jess is mastering this key, and you can do it too. It's not very hard when we minimize the variables.
Yeah, and you said it 100%, because when you minimize the variables, you put the weight on the front, you keep the arm straight, what you're also gonna do is you're gonna keep what we like to call the built-in draw on the face, which means that you already have offset here. So you're maintaining that offset. Everybody is asking, how do you hit a draw? Well, this is the beginning stages of how to hit a draw.
The holy grail of golf.
Yeah, the holy grail, absolutely. So everybody wants to stop slicing. You do this first, you learn how to do the low point in front of the ball, you're probably gonna stop slicing.
Yeah, so go ahead and do another one for us and just walk us through one more time.
Yep, so again, you know, 55 to 60% of my weight on my left leg. I'm really stabilizing here. My arms are straight. You can see I don't have my hands back, my weight back. I got my weight on the front, on my left leg, hands a little forward, low point.
Oh, nice.
And you can hit it, you know, you could hit it pretty solid. And again, it drew.
It did draw.
So, you know.
And it's still going.
Yeah, exactly. If you want more roll and you want to draw it, this is a great way to learn how to do it.
Oh, yeah. And every golfer we see pretty much wants to draw the ball.
Yeah.
They're tired of seeing the ball go slicing in the right woods. We've got one more bonus tip for you here. And this is, as you're doing the drill, you can build this up into the full swing.
Yes.
The feeling that we need to have over the golf ball, the bonus most important key in the golf swing, if you will. When we stand over the golf ball, we are at an inclined angle to the ground. So the key to having clean contact is to maintain your body's relationship to the ball that you established at address. And the way we're gonna do that, I want you to feel like you're keeping the middle of your chest, so this area here, feel like you're keeping it down pointed at the ball as you hit. This will prevent you from losing that relationship. So many golfers like to level out, and that's where you see the slice right there.
That's an unbelievable tip that I think there's a lot of people could benefit from, Tom, what you just said, the chest to the ground, because when you keep the buttons to the ground, that's going to keep you here maintained. So because we see so many people with, as you like to say, the shift and lift over here to the, then they move their buttons out and to the right. If you keep the buttons to the ground and the weight forward and the arms straight, you could really hit some solid golf shots. So when you set up to the ball and you have the weight forward and the arms straight, you're setting up in an inclined fashion. You're not hitting a ball that's level to your hips. Your ball's at the feet, so you got to tilt to the ground. I see so many people when they swing that they're lifting their chest away, and they would benefit from keeping the buttons to the ground, which will help them hit the ground.
And you can just hear that, like that ball turf interaction with these practice swings and the speed.
Yeah, you can create a lot of speed this way. You can create a lot of compression. You're gonna hit that. This is what all the best players in the world do. You could line up 200 of the top players in the world, LPGA, PGA Tour, line them up like this, and I guarantee you that none of them would hit behind the ball because they're not shifting to the right. They're not lifting their arms, pulling their arms in. They're keeping the weight forward, and they're hitting in front of that line. So that's
That sounds good.
Yeah, I love it. This is my favorite because here's one of the everybody says, oh, you're lifting your head and you're doing that, and we talked about that before, is that usually it's becoming coming from the arms breaking into your body, or, you know, pulling your arms in, because when you shift to the right and lift in or pull in, that's when you get that your arms break down and wrist break down. So again, you know, this is just a simple way, and we love, you know, Tom and I love to teach, we love to help you guys get better, is that this is just a simple way for you to really compress the golf ball and get better quicker, and that's what we want. So,
and so go ahead and demonstrate that buttons down feeling for him. We're still keeping the quarter to quarter swing, but he's just thinking chest staying down so that he doesn't lose that relationship, which is so important to have with the ground throughout the swing. That's why he's hitting the turf in front of the ball. He's keeping the chest down. If you can even watch his shoulder, it does go down a little bit. Yep. It doesn't level up. So go ahead and demonstrate that chest down feeling for the audience. Okay. You guys are gonna love this. It's gonna be so crispy from here.
So we're gonna go weight forward, 55 to 60% on the left, arms straight, buttons to the ground.
Nice.
Crispy.
Ooh. Did you hear that crack?
KFC.
Woo! Find your nearest KFC near you, your local Seguto Golf and Jess Frank Golf Academy.
That's awesome.
Dude, that was awesome.
Yeah, fantastic.
So, Jess's channel is very similar to Seguto Golf. He teaches a fun, body-friendly golf swing. It's really simple to execute. Our styles are nearly identical, so I think you'll find some value in checking out Jess's channel. And so what I'm gonna do is put Jess's channel in the channel side as a channel friend, so you can see him. You go to my channel, you'll find him on the right-hand side as a channel friend. You can see his content, it's really awesome, and it's along the same type of stuff that I've been teaching you to help you play your best golf right now. Thanks again for doing this video with me, Jess. I really think y'all are gonna love having his perspective on the golf swing. He's fun, body friendly, and simple. That's what we're trying to do here at Seguto Golf. That's what he's trying to do at Jess Frank Golf Academy. And so, anything you want to add in there for the audience, Jess?
I just want to tell you guys, I just want to tell Tom, thank you so much for having me here. You know, I love what you're doing. I love your energy. You know, you're making better golfers, and that's what we're all about. We just want you, the viewers, to get better, faster, have more fun on the course, and we like to help you. So Tom, thank you so much for having me.
Buckets of KFC you, Jess. Man, that was awesome.
Yeah, fantastic.
So go check out his channel and have a rocking week.